Tonight on NewsWatch, reaction from the Democratic National Convention to a party platform that doesn't mention God, even as Christian Democrats gather to pray.
Plus, Isaac is gone, but Operation Blessing makes sure the hurricane victims are not forgotten.
And a natural and simple solution to male infertility. We will tell you about the nutrient-rich food that's making the difference for many couples. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. And good evening, everyone. I'm Lee Webb. And damage control at the DNC after a godless move.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. A firestorm at the Democratic National Convention in Charlotte over issues they say you should never discuss in polite company: God and politics. It all started yesterday afternoon when CBN political reporter David Brody broke the news that the Democratic Party platform dropped references to God. The Republican ticket quickly picked up on the DNC's omission. Furious Democrats spent the day beating back charges that they are the godless party, issuing the day's first rebuttal at a prayer rally, no less. We have full coverage of the Democrats' response, beginning with David's report on what started it all.
Democrats took to the floor here in Charlotte to hear speeches and also take part in a traditional ritual approving the party's platform. But this year, something's different. There's not a single reference to God, despite the chairwoman of the Democratic National Committee telling CBN News this just a few days ago.
We really think it's important that we not allow the Republicans to corner the market on the faith community.
Yet the party's language seems to be moving in the opposite direction. Back in 2004, there were 7 platform references to God. Then in 2008, a single mention stating how everyone had the chance to make the most of their God-given potential. This year, that paragraph simply says, in America, hard work should pay off, responsibility should be rewarded, and each one of us should be able to go as far as our talent and drive take us. No God-given potential line, but to some here in Charlotte, it's not a problem.
I wouldn't worry about it. It doesn't bother me from the standpoint that I know where I stand. I know that there is one. And that's it.
The party platform is really just a document that really doesn't carry much weight at all. It doesn't set policy, it just lays out principles. But a Pew Research study actually shows that Americans pay more attention to the party's platform than they do the speeches of candidates Mitt Romney and Barack Obama. Some ministers are definitely paying attention. Reverend Michael Stevens pastors a Charlotte area church. Many of his members still struggle with whether to support the president this time around because of his support for same-sex marriage. That position also changed in the 2012 party platform.
It makes me feel as a pastor that there's all respect and reverence for the church and the clergy has been removed from the Democratic Party. They're willing to roll the dice and say, we can win without your votes, and we can win even if it means full frontal and being offensive.
Unlike 2008, this platform also leaves out any mention of Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. That's also an important issue for Christians. Democrat officials point out that there is a paragraph on the importance of faith.
The fact that we talk about faith more than 20 times in our platform, I'd go toe-to-toe with anybody about how we see the significance and importance of faith in American life.
Democrats have been holding daily prayer services down here, but the only headlines coming out of Charlotte on faith so far have not been flattering. David Brody, CBN News, at the Democratic National Convention.
President Obama's faith-based outreach responded to Davis' report at a prayer gathering this morning. White House correspondent Jennifer Wishon reports on the fireworks in Charlotte.
In a fiery sermon, the Democratic Party's pastor-in-chief told Democrats of faith not to put credence in the lie that faith is not an integral part of their party. His remarks came during a meeting of the Prayer Council, which is an opportunity for Democrats of all faiths to gather to pray, hear testimonies and inspirational stories. Here's part of how the Reverend Derek Harkins opened that meeting.
I had someone a long time ago say to me, it's not what you write down, it's how you live it out. And the temerity of individuals to cast aspersion on the value of faith because of a shift in a paragraph that wasn't even speaking about faith was using a term, God-given, in a much broader sense about economic parity, to cast the aspersion that that somehow means that God is excised from our work and from who we see ourselves as part of the American story is just unconscionable.
On opening night of the convention, Democrats voted unanimously to pass the party platform. And while the document does not include God, Reverend Harkins points out that party leaders called upon him time and again.
If you were counting, and you heard the word God, you couldn't stop counting at 12. You couldn't stop counting at 14. You couldn't stop counting at 19. You couldn't stop counting at 25. The New York Times, you know, they do the assessment of how many words are used, and you heard people speak about God 30 times last night.
This convention, under the leadership of Reverend Harkins, is offering more faith-related programming than any other Democratic convention. That includes daily morning interfaith prayer time and several meetings of the prayer council. There's even a prayer room. The headline that Democrats took God out of their party platform is not the one leaders wanted as they open their convention and make the case why President Obama should get 4 more years. But it is one party leaders are fiercely defending. Reporting from the Democratic National Convention in Charlotte, Jennifer Wishon, CBN News.
Joining us now from Charlotte is Fernando Cabrera. He's a delegate to the Democratic National Convention from New York City. He's also a city councilman representing the Bronx, and he pastors New Life International Outreach Church in that borough as well. Councilman Cabrera, thank you for being with us. What's your reaction to the word God being removed from the DNC's platform?
I felt that a party that really wants to be attentive to the people of faith, that God should have been mentioned. I mean, that's just the tradition. And I was very surprised.
Well, some might suggest, Councilman, that it's no surprise that a party that supports abortion and gay marriage would remove references to God. Do you feel that you and other Christian leaders in the Democratic Party still have a voice in the party?
Well, you know, we see ourselves as a reformers in the party, just like you have in the Republican Party. You have people who are trying to make the party more liberal. So there are some of us that are trying to bring the party to a more reasonable and intelligent approach to policy, especially in regards to gay marriage. As a Democrat, I'm very concerned in light of the fact that the average African-American, Latino, and Asian constituent and American is for traditional marriage, not for gay marriage. And so they're not following really the pulse of America. If you look at every election, every referendum where you... when the people were allowed to vote in this regard, in every single instance, they voted in favor of traditional marriage.
Councilman Cabrera, as I mentioned, you're also a pastor of a church in the Bronx. And pardon me for being direct with this question, but why would you remain as a Bible-believing Christian? Why would you remain in a party that would cause you to violate your conscience with regards to abortion and gay marriage?
Those of us who are in the party, who are for traditional marriage, who are pro-lifer, we don't feel that our conscience is being violated. As a matter of fact, we feel a calling to bring about change. And there are other issues that are very important, you know, the issues of justice, issues dealing with the poor. You see Isaiah 58, where people who pray and fasted, in which I'm a firm believer in praying and fasting, yet they were told you're not being attentive to the poor and the needs of those who are less fortunate. But it is a challenge. I'm not going to pretend to sit here and tell you that it's not a challenge. It is a challenge for us. But just like you find people in the Bible like Daniel and Joseph who were serving in atheistic or anti-Almighty God government, yet God had them there for a reason for such a time like this.
Councilman Fernando Cabrera, thank you for being with us and providing your thoughts.
Thank you.
The Democratic Party is also facing fire over a controversial section dealing with abortion. Pro-life groups say the platform supports taxpayer-funded abortions. They cite a section that says the party supports a woman's right to an abortion, quote, regardless of ability to pay. The Hyde Amendment prohibits using taxpayers' funds to pay for abortions. Polls show most Americans are against public-funded abortions.
President Obama's convention speech Thursday night is being moved indoors. The president planned to give the speech in Charlotte's 74,000-seat Bank of America football stadium. Now Obama officials say forecasters are predicting severe thunderstorms Thursday night, so they're moving the president inside to the Time Warner Cable Arena, which seats about 15,000. Republicans, though, claim the Democrats moved the speech because they fear they're afraid of a low turnout.
Former President Bill Clinton is the headliner at the convention tonight. Last night, First Lady Michelle Obama was at the podium saying her husband still stands behind working families. She said for the president, success isn't about how much money you make. It's about the difference you make in people's lives. President Obama and their daughters watched the First Lady's speech from the White House.
Being president doesn't change who you are. No, it reveals who you are.
The president is counting on turnout from Latino and women voters in November, but a new ABC News Washington Post poll shows the percentage of women who approve of the president has dropped 11 points since April. On the first night of the convention, delegates praised President Obama for helping win approval of health care legislation and for supporting gay marriage and abortion rights.
As the Democratic convention got underway, this news: the U.S. national debt has reached a new milestone, now topping $16 trillion. The new all-time high means the winner of the November presidential elections will have to pass a law raising the debt ceiling. That limit currently stands at $16.39 trillion. The debt has skyrocketed under President Obama, who has presided over four straight years of deficits over $1 trillion. Meanwhile, a new survey finds the World Economic Forum shows the United States' ability to compete on the global stage is down for the fourth year. U.S. competitiveness has now dropped to seventh place.
In Afghanistan, hundreds of soldiers have been fired or detained after a surge of insider attacks against foreign troops. The latest one involved three Australian soldiers killed by a man wearing an Afghan army uniform. He opened fire on the soldiers at the end of a long day of training. Australia's army chief says it's murder. The Afghan defense ministry called the attacks very serious and say they will use all of their resources to prevent these kinds of incidents.
The U.S. is accusing Iran of using Iraqi airspace to deliver weapons to Syria. Several prominent senators, including Joe Lieberman, are in Baghdad warning Iraqi leaders that the weapons pose a threat to Middle East stability. Iraq denies the allegation, saying the flights to Syria are only delivering humanitarian aid. Iraq says the U.S. has to show proof that Tehran is shipping weapons.
Coming up, Operation Blessing is in the trenches with some of the hardest hit victims of Hurricane Isaac.
Have you got a drawer full of knives that are about as dull as a doorstop?
Hi, Anthony Sullivan here for the Edge of Glory, the best knife sharpener money can buy. It's so precise, it'll turn this plastic credit card into a precision cutting instrument. The Edge of Glory is no ordinary knife sharpener. Its jewel-hardened teeth hone any blade to a razor's edge that'll put the bite back into your dullest knife. Tired of squashing tomatoes? Use the Edge of Glory to get perfect slices every time. It locks onto any smooth surface, then just draw the knife and that old knife cuts like new and ready for more. We took this plastic credit card and tried to cut a tomato. Nothing happens, but one, two, three, four, and now it's got an Edge of Glory that slices like magic. The Edge of Glory brings any knife back to life. It works on chef's knives, fillet knives, paring and peeling knives. I'm gonna put the Edge of Glory to the ultimate test and dull this knife using this grinder. It doesn't even have the power to cut this orange. Just run the knife through the Edge of Glory, two, three, four, and bring a dull knife back to life. You could spend up to $160 on a knife sharpener, or you can get the Edge of Glory for just $10.99. But it gets even better. Call now, and you'll get a complete three-piece knife set with your order. Use them to cut, peel, dice, or fillet just about anything. They're a $20 value, and they're yours free when you call. But we're still not done. If you order now, you can double this entire offer. That means you get two Edge of Glory sharpeners and two knife sets, a huge value, all for just $10.99. And remember, order now and find out about free shipping.
Call 1-800-299-3870 and get your Edge of Glory. But hurry, we're giving away a special offer on a second Edge of Glory and the knives with today's orders. So call 1-800-299-3870 and find out about free shipping. That's 1-800-299-3870. Call now.
Parts of the country are still feeling the effects of Hurricane Isaac. What's left of the storm is soaking the Northeast now. Many areas seeing a record amount of rainfall. Forecasters say the rain will continue for the next few days. In New Jersey, remnants of Isaac led to a powerful storm and even a funnel cloud sighting. Weather experts warn that other storms are gaining strength out over the Atlantic. Tropical storm Leslie, for example, is on a track that could take it towards Bermuda. The Gulf Coast, though, bore the brunt of Hurricane Isaac. And a week later, many Gulf Coast residents are still suffering.
Operation Blessing is serving hot meals in places like East Plaquemines Parish, Louisiana, where exhausted residents and emergency workers have so far received little help. Jody Harrington Geddes of Operation Blessing is there.
We are here in Laplace, Louisiana. Operation Blessing arrived here about 48 hours after landfall. Throughout this community, the water rose to the rooftops of houses. Behind me in this neighborhood, the water went to about 4 feet on these houses. The water is beginning to recede, but I'm standing still in about 2.5 feet of water. So Operation Blessing is working throughout the parish, and we will be here to help these residents recover.
We have never expected this to happen. St. John the Baptist Parish is between New Orleans and Baton Rouge. When Katrina hit, most of the New Orleans people migrated here. So we thought we were always safe.
It totally devastated everybody's life back here. A lot of people, they don't have lights, they don't have food, they don't have ice as we speak.
Thank you.
Thank you. It is a blessing. For you all, we wouldn't be able to eat anything right now. It's wonderful to see people coming in to help, and it make us feel special.
This local church served over 1,000 people between hot meals and the 40,000 pounds of food and supplies that came in from Operation Blessing. And of course, we know that food and water and MREs is very important, but Keisha was telling me that one of the hottest items was this hygiene kit.
Here you go. Get you a hot plate right over there.
What you all are doing, this is very important because these are everyday items. We can take a bath with soap if you don't have it.
It's good to be prayed for, but it's good to be prayed for with a hand up. So we do appreciate Operation Blessing.
Currently, our focus is hot meals, ice, and personal hygiene items. The power is out in this parish, but also there's still standing water. So we're waiting on the water to recede, and once the water recedes, Operation Blessing will be sending volunteer teams in to gut homes, remove debris, and just basically do anything necessary to help the people rebuild their lives.
Thanks, Jody. God bless you guys. And Operation Blessing has served nearly 13,000 meals so far in that region. If you want to help Operation Blessing in their effort, you can make a donation through CBN.com.
Up next, the simple food that could help couples who want to have a baby.
News.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
John Mapes is 42, mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? 60? 40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs, and they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
A federal judge says Massachusetts must provide a sex change operation for an inmate serving a life sentence. Michelle Kosolek was born a man, but received hormone treatments and is now living as a woman in an all-male prison. The judge ruled the surgery is the only way to treat what he called Kosolek's serious medical need. Critics denounced the ruling, calling an abuse of taxpayer dollars. They're pushing for it to be overturned.
Bad health could mean poor grades for teens. Researchers found metabolic syndrome can result in poor brain development. Metabolic syndrome is a combination of several major health problems, including obesity, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol. Teens with the syndrome could not read as well, scored worse on math tests, and took longer to get some things done. And some key parts of their brains were actually smaller. 1 in 12 American children and teenagers has metabolic syndrome. Researchers say they hope this study will encourage families to change their lifestyles. Well, when couples have trouble conceiving a child, they begin looking for answers. And for some, a simple diet change could make a big difference.
It turns out men who want to have a family should eat walnuts. According to new research, this wholesome, simple food dramatically improves fertility. Lori Johnson has more.
In America, approximately 1 in 7 couples has difficulty conceiving a child. About 40% of the time, it's because of a problem with the man. But a brand new study out of UCLA shows that eating a handful of walnuts every day substantially improves a man's fertility.
We found that walnuts were beneficial to male reproductive health in that they significantly increased sperm vitality, sperm motility, and sperm morphology, the shape of sperm. All of these are important indicators of male reproductive health.
The study looked at 117 healthy young men. Half of them ate 75 grams of raw walnuts a day, and after just 3 months were remarkably more fertile.
So I think it's very important. And, you know, eventually, you know, I want to have a family. I think this is something I'll definitely share with my family members, friends and family that, you know, could be useful. So I think it's definitely a breakthrough in men's health.
It's unusual for scientists to study nutrition in relation to male fertility. In fact, any kind of male reproductive study is rare.
And I think we need to start thinking about focusing on the importance of male health as well as female health in terms of pregnancy and healthy offspring.
Eating walnuts isn't just a good idea for men who want to have children. This superfood is a smart choice for all of us.
They're loaded with those important omega-3 fats, antioxidants, protein, and fiber. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
Up next, from a path of destruction to the road to forgiveness, a California man is carrying his cross across the county, all to save lives.
John Mapes is 42, mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? 60? 40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
Well, finally, bad decisions and drugs landed one California man in prison more than once.
Now he's using his checkered past to change lives, one painstaking step at a time.
It's not about me. I'm trying to get people's attention because I need their help.
Steve Fox is lugging a 22-pound cross across the county. He wants to raise awareness to the growing number of young people who are battling drug addiction just like he did, and the power of the cross to overcome it. He plans to cover more than 100 miles on his journey, and he's stopping to pray for others along the way.
Father God, I just ask right now that you'd be very big in Scott's life, Lord. There's kids out here sticking dirty needles in their arm, and they're losing, and they're hopeless. And then after that, they're headed to prison. Well, I've been to 8 prisons, and I don't want them to go.
Wow. Yeah, interestingly, Steve's 11-by-6-foot cross is the same dimensions as his old prison cell.
Oh, my goodness.
You can tell he's quite serious about this.
And to see the cross in a place, out of place, like not in church, out on the highway, is very powerful.
It is.
It's going to affect a lot of people. Well, God bless him. Keep him safe. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.